Waylon's longtime manager. He was getting paranoid. Waylon was buying too much cocaine on the road and here and there. And so they flew it in a package. It was a kilo of cocaine. And all of a sudden, boom, boom. In come four or five guys. They had their FBI and DEA on them. Oh, shit.
So long to you. Hope I don't make it blue. I think I'm gonna kill myself. Think I'm gonna kill myself. Apart we grow. Lord, I can't go on alone. I think I'm gonna kill myself. Think I'm gonna kill myself.
Thank you. They told me to be nice. I don't know what they meant by that. Thank you.
David Allan Coe was in a reform school at age 9, and in and out of prison most of his adult life.
Yeah! Yeah! Standing in a bedroom with a gun in my hand, pulling on the trigger just as fast as I can. I can hear her scream as she reaches for the lover beside her. Married by the Bible, she was only 16. I was fresh from prison trying to follow my.
Ex-convicts need somebody to identify with. There's another ex-convict, and men in prison are going to be ex-convicts someday. They need someone to identify with. And the only one that they really have is men that they see coming back to prison for committing crimes. And they never hear about any ex-convicts that do good.
Yeah! Morning found me lying on the floor in New Orleans, looking like the patches was about to eat my jeans. Feeling like my belly was a warehouse for the blues. And I sure miss my sweet cocaine, Carolina. Met her on an ocean liner, called her Cocaine Caroline. She was quite a lady then, I was 22. God knows how much I adored her, I just never could afford her cocaine. I get hooked on you. Goodbye, Cocaine Carolina. Me and you are through. I'm going back to Sandy Skag. She sure knows what to do. She don't love me for my money. She just wants my body, honey. Cocaine Carolina. How did I get hooked on you?
A rebel who refuses to sell out to the commercial pressures of the big record company. A singer who just wants to do his own thing and live the good life with his musician friends.
Hey, mama's in the kitchen and I hope she finds a bottle of whiskey to ease her mind. But me, I guess I'll just snort cocaine. Ed and daddy's in the back of cooking barbecue, yeah, stripped half naked like a do, but me, I guess I'll just strip my mind.
This is Hank Williams, Jr. If you don't like me, you kiss my fucking ass, baby. Stick it out of your goddamn fucking ass.
Come on. Come on. It'd be like Hitler playing golf with Netanyahu. Well, you know, they're the enemy. They're the enemy.
Who's the enemy?
Obama and Biden. Are you kidding? The Three Stooges.
We started to ride in Denver, Colorado. I made the first one, but I did not make the second show. Cause I met this girl there that brought about quite a big change. But I OD'd in Denver and I just can't remember her name. I guess you could say that my love life was not up to par. Many nights alone had left some permanent scars. She told me she'd love me, and I told her that I'd do the same. Then I OD'd in Denver, and I just can't remember her name. I brought it on myself, and I guess that I shouldn't complain. Doc says, son, you can't do any more of that cocaine. Well, she made me higher than all of those expensive things. But I OD'd in Denver, wish I could remember her name.
Suzanne and I used to live in this little apartment. Long Beach, California.
Yeehaw! Yeehaw!
It was all right. The weirdest thing about it was the landlord. He's one of those guys that come home from work every day and go out the garage. His own bullets.
My fucking ass, baby. We'll stick it out your goddamn fucking ass.
I tell y'all, I visited Guy and Susanna down in that apartment a couple times down there in Long Beach, and that landlord didn't bore me in the least. Yeah, I was in red alert when that dude was around.
Sometimes I don't know where this dirty road is taking me.
Sometimes I don't even know the reason why, but I guess I keep a gambling, lots of booze and lots of rambling. Well, it's easier than just a waiting around to die.
Yeehaw! Yeehaw!
All one time friends I had a ma, even had a pa. Well, he beat her with a belt once, cause she cried. She told him to take care of me, headed down to Tennessee. But it's easier than just a waiting around to die.
That point, I knew there was no out. There was no good thinking at all. There was no way out of it, so I just didn't care no more, so I went to the other stuff. I went to the heart, the drugs, and...
The bars are all closed. It's 4 in the morning. the morning, I must have shut them all down by the shape that I'm in. I lay my head on the wheel and the horn begins honking. The whole neighborhood knows that I'm home drunk again. If drinking don't kill me, her memory will. I can't hold out much longer the way that I feel. With the blood from my body, I could start my own steel. But if drinking don't kill me, her memory will. These old bones, they
Whiskey River, don't run dry. All I got, take care of me. Whiskey River, take my mind. Whiskey River, don't run dry. You're all I've got, take care of me. I'm drowning in a whiskey river, bathing my memory mind in the wetness of its soul. Feeling the amber current flowing from my mind and leaving heart you left so cold.
Colorado's taken in a ton by taxing it, which was how much got you started?
I started out when I was a kid smoking anything I could get. Corn silks, you know, cedar bark, and then rolled up ready when you start rolling up the water.
Now, my mama and my aunts got mad at me because they thought nobody in Littlefield knew that Grandpa drank. Everybody knew Grandpa drank. You know, I mean, he was the guy who would get drunk, and if they give him any trouble, he'd put his hand around a gas pump and whip half of the police department. They even called me one time and said, what are we going to do with your grandpa? And I was in Tennessee at the time, and I said, you best leave him alone, because you ain't going to win. I think Grandpa taught me to cuss.
In a place where no one knows us, we hold secret rendezvous. We laugh and joke as though it's right to do the things we do. You're someone else's darling, but when I'm holding you so close, why do I always feel the best when my conscience hurts the most? Why do I get such a thrill from wanting you so much when I know you can't be mine to keep but just to sometimes touch? In a place where no one knows us,
Our affair can't be exposed. Why do I always feel the best when my conscience hurts the most?
Someone I love don't want me hanging round. All she does is put me on and put me down. Tonight she's with a stranger at a party in her home, and I'm here at the tavern getting stoned. 'Cause if I gotta go, I'll go down swinging, where there's lights and laughter, booze and blondes, and lots of sad, sad singing. I'll sober up tomorrow and cry all day, I know. At least I'll go down swinging, what a swinging way.
Miles from the Mexican border, the days are getting shorter, nights are getting colder, his heart by the highway, he leans on her shoulder, just a little bit tired and a little bit older. The days keep on running down through the seasons, they're running like a prairie fire, wild with no reason, the devil's to pay. For the moment he sees, and still nothing is lost that's left to be leaving. He's got little to lose, his only companions are the liquor that he loves, the rambling and the gambling, the coyote answers from back in the canyon. He's hungry for more than plain understanding. Sometimes it gets hard, sometimes it's amusing, when kindness repays just an illusion, when blind men know best what to make of confusion, dead men know nothing at all.
Don't suppose you...